قدمت التعازي لضحايا الحادث الإجرامي في 11 أيلول، وتحدثت بعد ذلك، قلت لهم أن أنا رئيس الجمهورية جمهورية العراق سيد صدام حسين أرسل هذه الرسالة.
طيب التعزية هذه من عندك ولا وردت في رسالة الرئيس وأنت بعدين سويت لك كمقدمة؟
لا، التعزية مني،
من عندك؟
لم ترد في رسالة الرئيس.
نعم،
التعزية مني، وهي مسألة لياقة ومسألة طبيعية جدا. أنا أمثل دولة،
نعم،
ليس لدينا نحن يعني موقف لا إنساني لكي يعني أتجاهل هذه النقطة. وهذه القضية كانت يعني مؤثرة جدا في الواقع الأمريكي، فكان من اللياقة ومناسب جدا أن أتقدم بالتعزية. تقدمت بالتعزية في بداية الخطاب، ثم أبلغت الحضور أنني موجه من رئيسي بإلقاء هذه الرسالة التي بعثها، وهذه مقتطفات من الرسالة ضمن الوقت المحدد للخطاب. ما ألقيت الرسالة.
Ladies and gentlemen, this session is held a year after the tragic events of September 11th, and I would like to renew our condolences to the American people, especially the families of the victims of this tragedy, and express to them our deep sympathy. It gives me pleasure to express my sincere gratitude to the international community, states and organizations for this substantive position rejecting the US administration's threats against Iraq and for the calls they made for a comprehensive political solution to the impasse in the relationship between Iraq and the Security Council. In response to several appeals made by the UN Secretary General, peace-loving states and regional organizations, my government decided to allow the return of UN weapons inspectors without conditions as a first step towards a comprehensive solution that includes the lifting of the sanctions imposed on Iraq and the timely implementation of other provisions of relevant Security Council resolutions, including Resolution 687 of 1991. I was instructed by President of the Republic of Iraq, Mr. Saddam Hussein, to convey to you in the allotted time excerpts of a letter he addressed to the General Assembly, where His Excellency tackled Iraq's position on the latest developments in the relationship between Iraq and the Security Council. Following are excerpts from the letter, and I quote, in his speech at the General Assembly that was preceded and accompanied by noisy propaganda and extensive preparation, the US President, instead of paying attention to common issues of particular concern to humanity at large, he presented the security problems of his own country and the sacrifices it has suffered since the events of September 11th. It is a good sign that the United States has resorted for the first time after the end of the Cold War to the General Assembly to put forward one of the problems, after years of disregard to the weight, effect, and opinion of others. Nevertheless, the US President revealed his basic purpose when he jumped to the issue of Iraq without any introduction or acceptable progression. He portrayed this issue as if it were the most dangerous situation, not only for the life, security, and the future of the United States, but for the life, future, and security of the whole world. Along his generalizations, which implied deliberate insinuations, he presented the utmost distortions on the so-called nuclear, biological, chemical threats so as to make American citizens believe the deliberate insinuation that Iraq was linked to the American people's tragedy of September 11th. He seems to have assumed that the countries of the world are unaware of the American administration and its methods, nor do they know Iraq and its high sense of responsibility towards the humanity, its desire for peace and stability, or the fact that the Iraqis are our creative people in work, production, and innovation, in addition to being the heirs of the most ancient human civilizations. The US president talked about the importance of applying democracy by the government of Iraq. He pretended to care for the people of Iraq after he and other presidents before him have killed by the use of weapons, including depleted uranium, and by the blockade, which is now more than 12 years old, more than 1,700,000 innocent Iraqis out of a population of 25 million citizens. So after a long time of utilizing the American propaganda machine, along with official statements of lies, distortion, and falsehood, the focus was deliberately turned on inciting the American public against Iraq and pushing them to believe the U.S. administration schemes of aggression as a fait accompli, as if it were the solution or the necessary rescue that would allow American citizens to live in security and stability after what they had gone through in September 11 events.